Good morning, everybody. I'm going to present on the government strategies for the road safety for the 2030. What you see here is the first recorded accident in Sri Lanka, 1910. My content will be the government strategies and action. And I'll be explaining the how Save Life program is being adapted and the one slide on the global focus and the way forward. As you know, the government agenda, according to the Saubhagya Dakma, government has promised to rehabilitate 100,000 kilometers of roads in Sri Lanka. And there will be a new more highways will be added, completing the central highway, the highway from Kurunagal to Dambulla, and the Ruwanpur Expressway will be completed hopefully within next 4 years. That basically improve the rideability and the surface of the roads. This 100,000 including the roads in the rural. Then as you know that the when there is a less traffic, people tend to speed up the vehicle than usual. And there is a high potential of more and more accident. As Professor Dharmarth was talking about the number of death per day, we are talking like the maybe 8 or 9, 10 sometime. So we feel that by rehabilitation of carpeting of 100,000 kilometers of road, this country might increase the number of accident. So this is where we are. Some of the photograph of the recent accident. Rate has been increasing due to the construction of the road and the new vehicle coming into the market and the driver behavior and so forth. So what next is the question. Are we going this way or this way and this way and this way? As a ministry, we would like to see that a number of accidents will be reduced. So what we plan for this, we want to reduce. So in order to achieve this, our plan, we adopt the Save Life package declared by the United Nations. As a ministry, in order to achieve our target, we have out of 6 action, we can adopt 3 action. One is the save a speed management, infrastructure design and improvement, leadership on road safety. These are the 3 action that we can take as the ministry. Let me tell you about the speed management. There are in general making roundabout speed bumps and so forth that I'm not going to discuss in detail. We have the more comprehensive system in progress to implement the national speed limit regulation in Sri Lanka. This is what we are now more keen on implementing in order to manage the speed of the roads. When you go to the leadership on the road safety, while we are creating general thing, the ministry and the government of Sri Lanka are working to empower the road safety council as the key agency right now. But we understand that there is no responsible key agency in order to take the leadership for the road safety. That is another action taken by the government of Sri Lanka. When we go to the infrastructure design and improvement, there has been a lot of improvement, and we are implementing a lot of bypasses and underpass, and many, many, almost all the cities around the country right now, we are working on making the bypass and so forth. But another special attention we have taken care is a separate access from the through road. We understand that this is the one of the point where we have a lot of accident, because our roads are not the design road. What we have done is the usual road, except the highways. We have converted to at the beginning people walk, then maybe different kind of vehicles. Now we buses and so forth. We improve that road. Then we have never thought of how this access are coming. They are just directly coming. So these are the point where we get a lot of accident. So now the difficulty is the surrounded by this area, there has been a lot of construction. People are living. So very difficult to change it. The land is the matter. Acquisition is the huge amount of money, and that has a problem. But still, we are trying to, wherever critical location, to have the separate access from the through road. When you go to the next, I would like to tell you about a few approaches or kind of action from the government of Sri Lanka. We as a government, we are empowering the institute and enhancing the traffic laws of Sri Lanka. We create an ideal safe road example for the region. We keep on improving the red and critical road section of Sri Lanka. When you go to the empowering the institutions and the enhancing the traffic laws of Sri Lanka, we have the Road Safety Council of Sri Lanka. We have the Road Safety Unit of Road Development Authority of Sri Lanka. We are trying to empower these organizations, especially Road Safety Council of Sri Lanka, in order to be a mandating organization for empowering the laws, traffic laws in Sri Lanka. Another major short-term challenges that we are going to address right now, improving the vehicle calmness for the special, there will be a special gazette that is in progress with the Ministry of Transport on the speed limit. So that are the one of the key initiative that we have taken. Then we are creating the ideal safe road for example for the region. We have selected the Polonnaruwa bypass road as a special project by the ministry. You will see the design, and you will see how the construction is being done right now. So that will be a ideal safe road, or modern facilities and everything will be there. So after the learning the lesson out of this one, so we try to improve the road network, have a similar to the what we are doing in Polonnaruwa. Another area is the improvement of the red and critical road sections. Right now we have selected the 80 kilometer stretch from Anuradhapura to Padaniya, which is the one of the highest accident frequencies in Sri Lanka. The ministries are developing the section as a pilot project. Initial survey and assessment are completed for that section. You will see this is the Padaniya Anuradhapura road. As I told you, one of the highest accident frequencies in Sri Lanka. So we have completed the report. safety improvement in Padini and Anuradhapura Road, that is A28. So now we have got the allocation from this budget. We are going to part by part improve this road. Another initiative we have taken from the State Road Safety Improvement Program, we call it the Mahamaga Suratuma Safe Road. That has been almost formulated. This is a special program on the road safety with above strategies will be launched by the ministry soon. And the before ending, according to the global focus and the way forward, in the global level, rising awareness of the road safety issues and allow assessment and the progress toward the sustainable development goals. This is the national, global level, but nationally, we are keep working, focused on action, especially where the results are made public. Allow adjustment and activities as needed. So that we are trying to target on the road safety related SDG goals, good health and well-being. With that, I would like to conclude my presentation. Thank you so much.